did you know, walking up the east steps of the U.S. Supreme Court building, there's a row of the world's lawgivers. The one in the middle is Moses, holding the Ten Commandments. The huge oak doors of the Supreme Court also have the Ten Commandments engraved on each. And as you sit inside the courtroom, on the wall above the Supreme Court judge, is a display of the Ten Commandments.
Did you know the Liberty Bell is inscribed with Leviticus 25:10? Proclaim liberty throughout the land to all the inhabitants thereof.
Did you know in 1787 our central government was divided into three branches based on the model of government from Isaiah 33:22? The Lord is our judge, the Lord is our lawgiver, and the Lord is our king. He will save us.
Did you know every session of Congress begins with a prayer by a preacher whose salary's been paid by the taxpayer since 1789?
Did you know in the French-Indian War, 1755, George Washington commanded 1,300 troops. At the end, he was the only officer remaining on horseback. He found 4 bullet holes in his jacket, and he wrote his wife that God had protected him. 15 years later, the chief that fought against him traveled to meet the man that God wouldn't let die. The chief stated he'd commanded his braves to concentrate on killing Washington and had personally shot at him 17 times. This story and Washington's letter were printed in American history books until this century.
Did you know in 1782, the Congress of the United States' recommendation of the Holy Bible for use in all schools was installed?
Did you know, at his inauguration, George Washington summoned a Bible for the oath and added, "So help me God." Then he leaned over and kissed the Bible. This Bible tradition has been followed by almost every one of the 43 presidents inaugurated since then, including some who've used the very same Bible.
Did you know? Noah Webster said, "The Bible is America's basic textbook in all fields. Education is useless without the Bible."
Did you know? Not one of these words, separation, church, or state, even appears in the Constitution. Many think they're in the First Amendment, but they're not. It reads, "Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof."
How have we reached the point where everything done in the 233 years of this country is now suddenly wrong and unconstitutional? Psalm 33:12 says, "Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord."